Sup everybody, and welcome to Fallout 4 Versus. In this project, it's going to be me, I'm Blitz, versus Bob.
Hi.
And we're going to be doing a Versus. So, you might be wondering, what is a Versus? Bob, we can go ahead and start now while we explain this. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to sort of race to the end of the game, if there is an end of the game. I don't think there is. And we're going to see who could get to the highest level with the least amount of deaths. That's really the objective. We also have a point system that I believe is above our videos here on the layout. That's going to tally the points, and points are going to come into effect too. So, for every level up that we get, we gain a point, and every time we die, we lose a point.
Yep.
Seems pretty simple.
But we're going to do a little bit more than that, though.
Mm-hmm.
We're also going to implement a challenge system to mix things up a little bit, make this fun, and hopefully get the YouTube community involved.
Definitely.
What we want to do is have a randomized daily challenge, which could really be just about anything that we can imagine or that even you could imagine. Yeah, we have about 37 ideas picked out so far for just things that we might have to do in a given episode. So whatever the challenge is, accomplishing it will get you a certain number of points, more points for more difficult challenges. If you ignore it, you just don't get any points for it. But the other person, if they can pull it off, would actually, you know, pull ahead. So basically, you can accomplish the challenge in any way you want, as long as you're fulfilling the requirements. And it could be really anything, from collecting a certain number of caps to murdering someone and getting away with it, or anything in between.
Or being high the entire episode.
I like that one. That's a really good one, just being high on chems for the whole episode. So yeah, we're looking for ideas, just crazy stuff that would be fun to try to do, that you'd just like to see us, you know, both of us trying to get done. We mentioned, you know, 1 point for leveling up, another point, or a negative point for dying. Challenges would be worth anywhere from 1 to 5 points, depending on their difficulty. So the big focus of our verses is really more about the challenges than it is about the leveling up. Although leveling up does help.
And not dying.
Yeah.
Not dying is going to be key here.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah. So if you guys got any ideas, please make sure that you drop them in the comments below, and we'll take a look at them. This is a weekly series, so you know you got lots of time to leave us ideas, and we can implement them, no problem.
All right, finally made it to the character creation menu.
So the upload schedule for Fallout 4 is going to be, this episode should be up on both our channels. So after this, episode 2 is going to go up on Bob's channel, and episode 3 will be on my channel. We're just going to alternate them like that. Like I said, it's going to be once a week for now, because we do have other projects that we each are doing. You know, I've got Pokemon, Bob's got Skyrim, we got Battlefront coming out Tuesday. And I know we're going to be recording and playing a good chunk of that, and that'll be put up. So if this gets to be really super popular and you want to see 2 episodes a week, we should be able to accomplish that, but it all depends on you guys. You guys got to let us know what you want. So
that's basically the idea. And We would kind of just want to keep things mixed up a little bit. The whole idea of the challenges is that they're going to be random.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I wanted to mention. So we don't really necessarily know what we're going to have to do prior to starting the episode, which is going to make things interesting.
Yeah.
Remove all. Go.
Remove all.
For the extras on the character creation, there's a remove all option.
Oh, that's too much work. Alright. So, yeah. And just a little behind the scenes thing, this is our third time trying to do this.
Yeah, I was wondering if you were going to mention that.
Yeah, I'm going to mention it because...
Hey, It was an accident.
First time we recorded, we both kind of had some technical difficulties. I had some screw-ups with my video. Somebody recorded a 15 gig file.
I forgot to switch it to MP4.
But the last episode was just straight up Bob's fault. He forgot to hit the record button. So we did about 15 minutes of this, and he didn't record a thing.
Yeah. No excuse for that, I'm afraid.
So at this point, I just want to see a wasteland. I haven't seen a wasteland in a while.
Because we've been stuck in this dumb house.
This stupid tutorial.
Let's see if I can expedite getting through here. I forget the order of things you have to do to trigger nuclear war.
This is like my sixth time doing this intro. I think if I ever do another character on Fallout, I'm just going to blow through here as fast as I possibly can.
What you can do is save it right at the end of the vault, and then there's an option to change your character up right at the end.
Oh, there you go. That's what I'm doing. That'll be my new way of doing new games on this.
Yeah.
And I'll just change my character then, because... No.
All right, robot.
I've had enough of this.
I need a robot that washes dishes.
I have a somewhat robot that washes dishes.
Fun.
Is that a dishwasher, Jake?
It's a dishwasher. Very good, Bob.
Hey, kid. Knock it off.
Yay, finally.
Good morning, Vault-Tec.
Yeah, I don't care, dude. I really don't care. Yeah, so vast majority of the text is probably going to get skipped. This isn't a story playthrough. Like, we're not let's playing this. We are versus. And speed is a factor.
Yeah. It's going to be hard for me. Hopefully I can keep ahead in my single-player game so I actually know what all the dialogue means and what's going on.
Yeah.
Because I hate skipping dialogue. Okay, seriously. Oh, there's the doorbell.
No. I'm going to go here because I know...
Come on, dude.
I might even take one from here. Yeah, there we go. You all must be thinking I'm crazy, but trust me, I'm going to need that. Because this is not just your average playthrough. It's not a normal playthrough. It's very hard. And I don't do well in very hard difficulties. I just don't.
I do.
Well, your crazy difficulty.
Skyrim series probably knows that.
Anybody's seen that Skyrim series? That's I just don't understand. Like, it's fun to watch him play that. Don't get me wrong. Watching you do that and suffer is hilarious at times. But I could just never do it.
All things considered, for somebody who's new to the mod setup that I'm using, I handle myself okay. It's just the dang archers.
Yeah. Those archers. And the bears.
the bears are sneaky. Bears haven't gotten me yet. They came close a couple times.
They come out of nowhere, though.
There are also bears in this game, but they're hyped up on radiation.
Yeah. I haven't run into any bears. Like I said, I haven't played nearly as much as Bob has. Because
seriously,
I've been
robot?
Doing other things. Flashes, sounds of explosions.
We're trying to get confirmation. Come on, Cogsworth. Come on. There you go.
This guy on the TV needs to talk faster.
He needs to be like, hey, everybody, nukes inbound, good luck.
Yeah, wouldn't that just be like, hey, everybody, stop what you're doing, nukes, run. Why do this slow, drawn out, sad, I don't know, this could be the end of the world thing.
I don't know where that guy's TV station is, but if I was him, I don't think I'd still be sitting there on camera.
Well, I mean, I guess if you think about it, they don't have much choice. Where's he gonna go? Like, if you're not part of a vault, you basically just hide in your house, I guess, and pray that it doesn't hit close.
At least try to find a basement. I mean,
what is a basement gonna do against a nuke?
It depends on how far you are away from it.
I guess.
I mean, within a certain range, everything's going to pretty much get turned to glass. But...
Move. Exactly, so there's no place to hide. I guess all you could do is pray that instead of being completely obliterated, you get ghoulified.
Assuming this guy's in Boston, though, he's... I went, whoa, frame rate. What the heck?
We're gonna be I don't okay. know. Don't, no, don't do this, Bob. Don't do this.
Run! Everybody panic!
Are you good?
It's the end of the world! I'm leaving my baby behind. I'm out of here.
You're leaving the baby behind? That's cold.
You'll be fine.
He'll be fine. It's just a baby. And I'm the one that doesn't like kids. Jeez.
My frame rate is kind of freaking out right now. I'm
what's
sort of wondering what's going on.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
I'm in the program. Let me in.
Everyone please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
Yeah, I'm going. You know this would be easy if I could run? If I could run?
Vault 111. A better future underground.
Yay, we survived.
I want to fly in a vertibird.
During a nuclear apocalypse, you want to fly.
Thanks.
Maybe not now.
I'm just saying, nukes tend to have this effect on electronics of killing them. Which could, you know, cause you to crash.
Whoa! Here it comes. Everybody hit the deck.
And Bob's game's gonna crash.
Oh, I think it's okay. I think it's just that opening scene. Probably because there's so many NPCs running around.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
And there's still foliage.
True. The details of that first little area are pretty high. Obviously, in a wasteland situation, that's not going to be the case. We'll be good.
Yeah. All the shrubberies are gone. Oh, wait, let's read the rules. For your safety, kindly do not put your hand in between the gates.
As Bob wastes time reading rules.
I'm going to go put my hand in between the gates.
Put the baby's hand in between the gates.
Jake, that is terrible.
You're the one that left it out to die in a nuclear apocalypse!
Hey, it caught up, okay? Excuse me, sir.
You're a terrible mother.
They were fine. They made it alive. All ended well. I clearly made the right decisions. What's up, everybody? Oh, the doctor is, like, jogging down the hallway to keep up with me.
Well, good for him. He knows where his priorities lie.
Yep.
And that's in making sure that you get frozen.
I don't want to get frozen.
I'm gonna kill both of you. I'm sure I will kill both of them. Well, at least one of them I'm going to kill.
Yeah, I'm wondering how long ago did that happen? Because you go back to sleep again.
Right?
So how many years have gone past? Is Sean still a baby?
See, I think the kid's a grown up.
I think so too. I feel like that would be the thing they would do.
I think you go back to sleep for another 20 to 30 years, something like that. But I don't know. That's just.
What if your kid's older than you are when you get out?
Well, now that's altogether possible, too. It could be, you know, 70 years or so.
Then you can blame the kid for not finding you.
Well, my guess is that the kid got indoctrinated by Mr. Mysterious Figure there. That's my guess. Yeah, they definitely do cryo you again. Which is just not nice. It's not nice.
You're just getting warmed up. Only to be refrozen.
And it's not like you even knew you were going to get frozen in the first place.
That's the thing about Vault Tech. They're not very nice people.
I know. They make it sound like they were going to save everybody. When the truth of it was, they just wanted to experiment on people.
They're like GLaDOS from Portal. It's like everything's all about science and testing.
Come on, come on, come on.
You gotta respect that, though, to some extent.
Right.
Okay. And we all loved GLaDOS. Let's face it, who doesn't love GLaDOS? Come on.
Nobody hates GLaDOS.
Mm-mm.
I promise.
Oh, wait, there's nothing in there. I know where all the stuff is now.
Let me out.
Nope.
Let me
out. You have to stay.
He's got a gun. Looks like a revolver.
You have to stay right where you're at.
I can't tell from in here, but that definitely looks like a really sweet revolver. Yeah, that's definitely a revolver.
Toy.
Yes. A backup? What does that mean?
Oh, and if anybody didn't know, they changed the crafting system in this game, so you're going to watch us pick up every single little cup, clipboard, everything.
Oh, yes. There isn't, like, one thing I've found that can't be crafted into anything, as far as I know.
What?
A folder. Just a regular manila folder.
Uh-huh.
That's it. That's the only thing I've found that seems to have absolutely no use.
What the hell?
Interesting.
And I might even be wrong about that.
And it's no longer useless to pick up meat, because you can just flat cook the meat.
Yep. There's no survival skill anymore.
Nah, who needs that?
Okay. Oh wait, that's right. You gotta open up the pod that your spouse was in.
And you gotta get the wedding ring.
That is the only pod in here that opens up.
Yep.
I checked all of them.
Yep. Alright, I need to scoop up the game. Alright, so I got the game.
Oh yeah, you gotta have Red Menace.
Well, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Donkey Kong.
Taking everything.
Alright, time to go destroy some more roaches.
People got, like, their coffee cups sitting in the cryogenic freeze room. I feel like
really?
The coffee wouldn't be very good at this point. Cryogenic.
Cryo! Learn to English, Bob. What are you doing over here? Weird little roach.
Hammers. Wrenches. I have a ton of steel in my single player game. I guess you seem to find that a lot.
Well, doesn't that get security baton? Can't you break a lot of things down into steel?
Yes, quite a bit. That's also where I've gotten some of it from. Ensel, Nuka-Cola, Stimpak. Anything you do on the security terminal here, I don't remember.
Alright, I got me a gun.
Security law operation. Nope. Nothing useful there.
Nothing can stand in my way. I have a crappy little 10 mil. Oh, and you might have noticed when I got hit by those stupid rad roaches, I got radiation damage.
Nice.
Yeah, radiation works much differently.
Yes. Instead of just giving you stuff like debuffs, it actually takes away your health.
Yeah, it basically lowers your max health.
Which I admit, I am not a big fan of. It just makes things harder.
I actually quite like that mechanic. I think the debuffs were all kind of a little confusing and weird.
Alright.
I have to take every beer bottle in existence. Here they are. Your bottle, I'm assuming, gives you glass. Coffee cups are ceramics. The crafting in this game is just crazy. So, you have a recreation terminal.
That's control.
If one game on one computer that everybody has to share for all the 180 days that they were in here or whatever.
Right?
I get that.
That's crazy. I would obviously go insane.
I mean, Donkey Kong's a great game, sure, the original, but I mean, only so long you can play Donkey Kong. And 180 days, it's not gonna work for me. Anything else in here? I think this room is largely useless.
Probably.
The room with the beds in it. I don't think there's anything in here. Okay.
Luckily, I do have an alternate here that I will be using as I struggle to kill rad roaches. Because I can't aim, free aim worth crap.
I'm here, little rad roach.
And then I just totally whiff. That was good.
Is this all that's left?
Ah, don't spit at me. What's wrong with you?
Okay, time to get a new toy.
New toy? Don't you already have the 10mm pistol?
No, I needed a new toy.
Hi guys! God. Get away from me. I'm already getting all irradiated. I need a gun.
You have a gun.
I don't yet.
Really, you're getting owned by the first two rad roaches.
Now I got a gun. I want this gun, but we can't have that gun yet.
No, we want that gun, but no.
I want the cryolator.
That would make my life easier.
Just freeze a deathclaw right where it's standing. Wouldn't that be great?
You are not allowed to move, Mr. Deathclaw.
Stand back. Now hold still while I slowly break your neck.
By punching you.
Take a great big sledgehammer and just crack that thing in half. Ah, there we go. A bunch of bobby pins. Excellent.
Wait, a bunch of bobby pins?
Yeah, got like 7 of them.
Wait, how did you get 7 of them?
They're in the overseer's bathroom. In the mirror.
Gosh.
There's like a little mirror cupboard.
Oh, well. I wondered why I was only ever allowed to have 1 bobby pin.
Oh, yep, that's right. Gotta use the computer. Open tunnel!
Come on! This is the slowest door ever!
Oh, this is where I gotta kill me some roaches. Oh my gosh, they all jumped out at the same time.
Enjoy your return to the surface. Thanks!
Oh, I missed.
I'm going to the... a barren wasteland. Yay!
Right. Too many roaches! They're all over me.
You're gonna die in the first episode.
Nope, not gonna happen. I'm using up a bunch of ammo, though. There we go. I just need to get somewhere where they weren't in my face. Got him.
Why don't you just use your security baton at one shot?
Well, because the last 3 times I've done this, I hit all 6 roaches with 6 shots.
Uh-huh.
Perfectly.
I don't think I've ever done that. All right, so
fine.
We are out.
Cook all of them and eat them later. Get all my health back.
Well, yeah, of course.
They deserve.
Where is that? It's over there, I think. I don't remember. Let's go talk to Mr. Stupid Robot here.
Mr. Stupid Robot. Now that's not very nice.
Well, he is a stupid robot.
Oops, I just had a... We've been playing Dying Light a lot recently. I just tried to activate my flashlight.
You have a flashlight. I believe it's...
Yes, it's on my Pip-Boy, which I'm just now picking up.
Yay, I persuaded the stupid robot to talk to me.
Stay with me, pal. Focus. Thank you, Codsworth.
Now, shall we?
All right.
All right. I got some bugs to squash. Me and my little robot pal here.
Who's gonna 64 kilobyte Pip-Boy.
Who's gonna do all the hard work because... Well... he's gonna get stuck. Nope, he's stuck on a wall. Are you kidding me?! What the... Yeah, so Codsworth got stuck.
Aww. He's not doing so good with the whole killing the bugs thing.
No. He is now.
Almost missed a box of 10 mil ammo. That'd have been terrible.
Yeah, I got your back. As long as you can kill one of them, I got the other two. What is a subway token good for?
Riding the subway?
Okay, let's see if we can get this on our first try. No.
Whoa! Whoa. I'm riding the bridge thing.
No. Oh, come on. Yes! Success!
Nice. I hope the game is nice and gives me back my health when I get out of here, but I don't think it will.
Give you back what?
I lost like a third of my health when those rad roaches got all over me.
Oh no, you ain't getting that back. You ain't getting that back.
Going up! I'm a little bit behind Jake, I think.
A little? Nuka-Cola. Cannot go wrong with Nuka-Cola. It's okay. The advantage that I'm holding right now will get erased very quickly. Very, very quickly.
From dying?
Oh, wow.
I have a feeling Jake's going to level up faster than me, but I'm going to die less often.
Yeah, that's fair.
Alright, I made it out.
Hey, Codsworth.
No, they're not.
Thanks for trying. You can't. Thanks for your help.
Good luck, sir.
Duff.
Okay, time to pilfer everything in this little town.
My frame rate still isn't that great out here. Oh. I think it's got something to do with running in a resolution that the game doesn't really like. Or that my monitor doesn't really like, I don't know. It should run better in a lower resolution.
Yeah.
It's still working, though, so I can...
Mine's working fine. We're playing the same game.
Yeah, well, you're playing on a laptop with the screen designed for...
Hey, it's a powerful laptop.
Okay, fair.
That actually barely runs it. But it does, as long as I've, like, it's at its at least amount of extra stuff happening in the background as possible. If that makes any sense, because it doesn't.
Press left alt to sprint. Okay.
Wait, can I pick that up? No. Oh, yeah, and you'll probably notice there's a difference between us and the fact that he's playing with his mouse and keyboard, and I'm actually playing with a 360 controller.
Oh yeah, mine's going to be a lot twitchier. Oh, I know why it's probably going a little slower. Duh, I have a video recorder going.
Well, I would hope so. We don't need another repeat of that. Transfer. Is anything worthwhile here? No. Alright, we're just going to dump all the junk in here because I don't need it at the moment.
I forgot. Before I talk to Cogsworth, there's something I need to do.
What? What?
Well, we want to increase my odds of passing his persuasion check. Oh, bugs.
Yeah?
So, I look around for a, oh, come on. Seriously? Freaking bugs.
Well?
I look around for a, like a piece of clothing to wear that boosts your charisma.
Well, I don't think you can fail that first one, Bob.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it's scripted.
I gotta quit letting these bugs hit the jump on me.
Nah, you don't. They deserve a fair fight.
Anyway, somebody around here is gonna have...
stuff.
Something. Different outfit of some sort. Always use oil. Kind of an important resource.
Yeah, I haven't really gotten that far into it to know whether or not how important stuff is. So I just scoop everything up that I can find.
I think pretty much everything is important to some extent. Yes. Okay, let's see if I can pick a lock without failing.
I passed my first one.
I'm not used to being able to pick locks.
Why? Oh, yeah, Skyrim. Duh.
My other series is like impossible.
Okay, so we've already went in there. I've pilfered everything from that one. Where's that super safe? I know there's a super safe in this place. I just don't remember where it's at.
Did you remember to set a timer, Jake?
Yep, it's gone.
Okay, good.
Yep.
I think I got what I needed. Let's see here. What does the checkered shirt do?
Nothing.
That boosts charisma. Now I'll go talk to the robot.
I still think it's scripted and you can't fail it unless you don't do it.
Going on, Cogsworth.
Fuses, I'm sure, are important. Shoddy ammo? Is that what that is? Yep. I will take some shoddy ammo. Dang it, this is not the right house.
Oh no!
What did you do, fail it?
I just realized. No, I forgot to grab the sunglasses when I left the vault, or the glasses when I left the vault.
Oh, you know what? I forgot them too.
Yeah, there's a pair of glasses in there that boost your perception.
I forgot them too.
Oh well. I'm sure there are other glasses in the wasteland.
I would assume so. This has got to be it. Oh, there's a screwdriver. I'll take that. I don't know what it's for, but I'm still going to take it.
Two centuries late for dinner.
These are the blowfly ones. I already cleared this house. That one. There. That's the one I want. I think this is the one I want. Dog bowl. I found a dog bowl.
Plastic. I'm assuming.
I would assume so. Oop, campfire. Cooking station, whatever.
Alright, Cogman, let's go.
Bloatfly. Grilled bloatfly. Grill that road right. Hey! What the? Where did you come from?
I love how Cogsworth, like, trash talks these things. Oh, crap. Holy crap.
I got snuck up on by a rad roach. I don't know how that happened.
Cogsworth just about set me on fire, I think. He went down a hallway, and I went to follow, but a bloatfly got in between us, and he turned around and just started flamethrowing stuff.
Now that would be funny. Bob's first death is Cogsworth setting him on fire.
Just collateral damage. And there goes Bob.
That would be hilarious. I'm sorry. That would be just absolutely hilarious. Stuff. Yeah, it's actually very important, I think, to pilfer this town before you move on to the next area, because... Oh, the next area. I don't think I've... Of the times I've gotten through it, I don't think I've ever gotten through it without dying at least once.
Oh, in, what's the place? Concord?
Yeah.
I know how to do it.
Well, I know how to do it. I just... Something always kills me. At least the last time I found the actual weapon I needed. Last time I didn't even find that. First time. That was bad. Where is that safe? This is driving me nuts. Can't get over the fence. I'm used to just hopping over fences.
Vaulting them.
Wait, this is it.
Alright, I think I'm off the hook now. Cogsworth is just going to hang around here. I can take, like, everything in the world that I would ever want.
Yeah, but you're lagging behind. Houses.
Yeah, but I'm getting some stuff.
No, I've already been in this. This is the blowfly one. All right, you know what? I give up. I know there's a super safe in here somewhere that's, like, mined.
Oh, yeah, I know exactly which house that's in.
I don't remember which house that was in.
I'm walking to it right now.
It's driving me nuts.
Of course, with this being a competition, I would never tell you.
No. Of course you wouldn't.
Yep. It's right. It's actually this one right here.
Because that tells me a lot.
Watching?
It's
anyone
this
watching?
One right here.
No, this is for the viewers,
uh-huh.
Jake. This isn't for you.
Okay.
I'm in it right
stupid
now.
Stupid safe. Ooh, I'll take the cap stash, though.
And there's a gun in here.
Nuka-Cola bottle. Some glass.
Did you see that bomb the first time?
Yes.
I came through here?
They tried to get me, but it failed.
It's a pretty easy one to see, but...
He thinks I don't see him. He thinks I don't see him. Well, guess what? I saw you, Mr. Radroach!
Oh, I broke it. I broke the bobby pin.
What the? What the?
Yeah, here we go. Shotgun
shit. The Radroach just threw a basket at me.
It threw a basket at
me.
Quite the battle strategy.
I just caught me off guard.
Okay, RC.
I got a Nuka-Cola cherry.
I have to hack this computer. Got it.
Okay. Gotta pick my way in. No! Bad bobby pins. Bad. Don't break.
I hack computers just for the experience, if nothing else.
Well, I think it's... Thanks. I think it's to play that tape that you're given.
Yeah, although I think you can play that on your Pip-Boy.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can play Red Menace on the Pip-Boy, though. Oh, not even fair. I shot you. Stupid roaches.
They're sneaky.
They do tend to sneak up on you.
Screwdriver.
Now, I believe there's another safe in a different house to actually read about on the computer in the house that I was just in.
I think I already picked that one. I knew where that one was.
Fire extinguisher. Toss that in my pocket and carry it around.
Ooh, there's a 10 mil. I found the house.
Oh, wait. This safe has an advanced lock. I can't pick that. I can't even try to pick that.
Disarm bomb.
Alright.
Come on.
I'm gonna head to Concord.
Already?
Yep.
No, dang it. You're gonna miss out on all the stuff.
Well, I'll be coming back here later.
Yes. Thank you, game. Okay, time to hack this computer.
Oh, I just got a new outfit.
Nothing.
Dog with a tire iron staked into it.
Oh, I love. I do not much care for the hacking system in this game. No.
I actually quite like it. I think it's a lot of fun.
I can never get it. Nothing. Really? Nothing? See, yeah.
Hey, doggy.
People are probably just
like
laughing at me. Trying to hack this computer.
That
should be something I'm good at.
It actually made the dog a lot less annoying in this game. What'd you find? Says he found something.
Yeah, it says that sometimes. Now you're gonna get jumped by a bunch of moles.
We'll get him.
Nah, you're gonna die.
What are you howling over?
Nope.
I know he's found a hard hat for me before, but I don't ever...
Oh, that would be nice.
I don't know where he gets it from, though.
Stop. One. No.
Buddy, where are you going? Oh, he's just moving along with me. He kind of runs out ahead of you.
Yeah, he which does. Which is...
It's actually very useful, because... You want the dog to go take point. Uh-oh, here they come. Heard one behind me.
This
where were you?
Is I think the devil. Man. There, finally.
Holy crap! Hi guys.
I just wanted
the
XP for it.
They're everywhere.
Yeah, Bob's dying. Although what Bob's probably gonna do is actually he's probably gonna gain a level here, which is unfortunate. Hey, I want that syringe.
Get off of me. Jeez, stupid.
Bob, did you remember to take your junk to the...
Workbench?
The workbench?
I will.
No, you didn't, though, did you?
I'll get it.
But which workbench are you taking it to?
I put mine in the gas station.
Oh.
I like the gas station. There. Store all a lot of dead mole rats. And I leveled up.
I knew he was going to do that.
Haha, I get a point.
Not that one. Well, I'm gonna mod my gun real quick because I'm probably going to need it.
I am going to. I'm gonna get a perk, actually.
Let's go with that.
I kind of like to start off with Scrounger. Just find
Scrounger.
Extra ammo. Yeah.
Okay, so I increased my pistol. I can scrap these. No. Scrap one of you.
Okay, so I have claimed this workshop.
That's nice.
Did you know that if you go up to a workshop and hit transfer, you can actually... Whoop. You can actually auto-throw, like, all your junk into it?
Yeah. You didn't?
I just figured that out a couple days ago.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I got that.
Although, keep in mind, I was a little behind getting Ooh. Fallout because, Steam apparently decided it was going to decline a perfectly good credit card.
Bob had some real technical difficulties when that came around. That was actually kind of funny.
That was terrible.
It was terrible at the time, but it's funny now that we look back on it.
Alright, well, let's see what mods I can do. I'm not sure what I have available to change my weapons just yet.
I got a bowler hat.
What can I do with a pipe pistol?
I don't know.
Well, nothing yet. I need adhesives. I need more junk.
Look at me, I got a hat.
I got a funny looking hat.
My funny looking hat's better than your funny looking hat.
Looks like a Russian hat of some sort.
A Russian hat?
Yeah, I don't know what. Like a winter hat of some sort. Okay, so I actually do need stuff from the town. I need adhesives and more things, so I have to run back out there and get some junk. I thought I had enough to make mods to the weapons I wanted, but I do not.
I got shotgun.
I have frag grenades.
I do too.
Yeah, you found those. Oh, and very easy to just roast up some rad roaches.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with that. Yep, that works.
Easy healing.
All right, Bob, are you at a stopping point?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, I think this is a good time to stop. We're coming up on 45 minutes, so before I head into the rocket area, I think this is a good point to end the episode. So remember, in the next episode, it's going to be over on Bob's channel, so you want to check the description for a link to his channel. Go over there and subscribe to him so that you don't miss any episodes. Bob, do you have anything that you want to add before we take it out?
No, that's pretty much it. I was just going to say in the next episode, we'll go ahead and start doing those challenges. So,
yes, like definitely. I said, we'll have challenges anything. For the next one.
And we want your opinions and input on just, you know, whatever you want the challenge to be, you know. And if we like it, we might put it in if it's, you know, if it's something that we think would be interesting.
All right. So, if you enjoyed this episode, make sure that you like, comment, subscribe. And until next time, this is Blitz and Bob.
Yep.
Signing off.